Hey everyone, my name is Kanan Tivedi and I am basically a guitar instructor and a guitar player since last 3 years. You can consider this video as a first guitar lesson, as I would be considering all of you that you have just bought the guitar and placed it at your home, but you haven't touched it yet. So I'll keep in mind that all of you can take this video as a reference of how I teach, how you can like benefit from my teachings. Let's get into the guitar lesson number one. Let's start with the parts of guitar. Okay. I'll start from top, then I'll go to bottom. Like, this is a very basic and a beginner guitar, and I would suggest you to buy a very basic guitar, like around 5,000 Indian rupees. You'll get a decent acoustic guitar. Okay. Don't buy a semi-acoustic if you are just starting out with your guitar journey. Always buy an acoustic guitar. That is what I recommend to all of my students. Why? Because semi-acoustic guitar are actually the guitar that you plug into an amplifier to produce a louder sound. Amplifier is a speaker. So you connect one end of wire to the guitar and other end of the wire to the amplifier, and when you like strum it, it produces a brighter, warmer sound directly into that speaker. But why I would not suggest you to buy those type of guitar, because by the time you end up learning your guitar, the electronics you have inside your guitar might get damaged, or they won't sound as fresh. Yeah, you should always try to pick an acoustic guitar if you are buying, and always try to like keep it in the range of 10,000 Indian rupees. Some companies I would suggest are Caps, Yamaha. Yamaha makes really good guitars. Then Pluto, Gibson, Fender, and there are many others. Yeah, that's it about the buying tips. And let's go into, if you have already bought it, don't worry. These are called tuning packs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have 6 tuning packs. That means each tuning pack is connected to a string, which means I have 6 strings on my guitar. Now, so 6 strings, and now this metal rod kind of thing, small kind of thing, are called frets, F-R-E-T-S, and this are called guides, the dots that you see on guitar. Some may have it, some may have not. The dots are used as a reference for the guitar player, like where is he playing, where on what fret is he actually playing the guitar. So these dots help us a lot in the initial sessions. Once you learn the guitar, you don't even have to look at the fretboard to get the sound. So once in the beginning, yeah. So that was all about this section. Like the top section, we have the keys, like the knobs for tuning guitar. These are the attach that attaches the strings, and this is a bone, and which like fits in the strings. These are the frets to sing a stunt. Now this thing you see, this is called a neck. That's the body of the guitar. This is a sound hole, and that is called a bridge. Not that bridge, that is bridge, B-R-I-D. It sounds and spells the same, but the meaning is different. It's a guitar bridge. So the bridge hold the strings to the body of the guitar, and these are called bridge pins. So that is all about the parts of the guitar. If you have a machine kind of thing over top, that is called a pickup. You might have a tuner inbuilt. You can buy an external tuner. That's a capo. You have to buy a capo initially. The capo is a very useful tool. Let me show you. This is a capo. That's a clip-on capo. And this is a tuner. Clip-on tuner. Okay. Then we have to like sit. Okay, have to like hold the guitar. Yeah, sit straight, place the guitar on the lap, and make sure you get comfortable with it initially. Okay, you just want to be comfortable with it. Don't like directly dive into the playing stuff. Okay, get comfortable.
That is how basically the guitar is held.
Yeah, like this. Got it.
Now how to hold the pick?
Do it like this, thumbs up. Okay, this finger gets curved, so like it's like okay, and this goes over here, and okay, like okay. So instead of like this, this kind of like this, okay. And this part should be facing towards you. This part, the tip of the guitar, the tip of the pick should be facing towards you. Just know that this part, the tip should be facing towards you. And then like that. So that's, that is how we hold the guitar, and that is how we hold a pick also. Yeah, now hold this pick, this sound hole, get it inside, not too much inside, just the tip should touch the first string above it. So it should be like this. See the first string above it, your pick, and you do a downstroke. Keep doing it until you get comfortable, like it becomes smoother for you in the downstrokes. Just keep doing it on first string, then we move towards the second string. Third string, fourth string, fifth string, sixth string. Likewise, you have to do it continuously, 10 times on each string. Not on this bit. Let us okay. Let me show you a thing called metronome before that. So if you search on the Google Play Store, there is an app called Guitar Tuner and there is an app called Metronome. So that is how UI of a metronome looks. If I set it to 60, always set it to 60 while starting out, it will give you this kind of sound. Tick, tick, tick. So how you should do is, at every click, you should be doing downstrokes. That is metronome, okay. Just to remind you again, that is called metronome, metronome. Download it, open it, set it to 60 and start playing. 4 times on each string, you have to do 10 times. That's it. And once you are done with that 10, then you will move towards 5 on the speed of 60. Okay, I'm doing it fast. Then 3, twice, once. We did from bottom to top, then we will be doing top to bottom. Same thing, 10 times, 5 times, thrice, twice and once. So once you are done with that, like from bottom to top and top to bottom, we will get into an exercise number 2 for your right hand technique, that is called alternate string exercise. So what we do is, we now pluck the first string. Then we skip the second string and we plug the third string. Then we skip the fourth string and plug the fifth string. So it's like 1, 3, 5. 1, 3, 5. Then we do 2, 4, 6. So this time we'll play, plug the second string, skip the third string, plug the fourth string, skip the fifth string, plug the sixth string. So first 1, 3, 5, then 2, 4, 6, and same thing moving downwards, 6, 4, 2, 5, 3, 1. Got it? We skipped one string, now we'll skip two strings. 1, skip 2, skip 3, 4, 2, 5, 3, 6, 6, 3, 5, 2, 4, 1. Okay, so string is like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so that is how the strings are numbered. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Got it?
Now we'll skip 3 strings. So 1, skip 2nd, skip 3rd, skip 4th, play the 5th. So 1, 5, 2, 6. Again, 6, 2, 5, 1. Got it?
Yeah.
Now you don't need to skip it. So once you are done with bottom to top, top to bottom, skipping exercises, then you have developed a pretty nice right hand technique. Okay, on the down strokes. So that's the back of the guitar. So where you will place your thumb, I'll demonstrate it to you. The thumb would go this, that's the middle section of your guitar. Thumb would go right around the center, like that's the sweet spot. That is where you should keep your thumb. You can keep it like this once you learn the guitar, but for now always keep it down, not over here, not in the middle, just above the middle section. So yeah, that is where your thumb goes. And now about this, like fretting it, it should be like claw. Okay, so if this is my guitar, I'm doing it like the thumb and see like that. So see, there should be distance. Okay, it should not be like this. There should be some amount of distance between your guitar body, like this, and so it should be curved like this. It should be like a C shape basically. Yeah, so once you attain this, you can start this exercise number 1. Yeah, also I told you like these are called frets, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now where to keep your finger while you are playing it? Just behind the frets. Okay, that is where you keep your fingers. This is a fret. I'll place my finger just behind it. Okay, not on top of it, just behind it. And I'll start 1, 2, 3, 4. When I say 1 means first fret, first finger, first fret, first finger. When I say 2, then I'll play second fret, second finger. When I say 3, then I play third fret, third finger, 4, then fourth fret, fourth finger, like this. So 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. I do it on a metronome. Okay, that could be fast for beginners. I'll keep it on 40. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. That's all we have to do. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm going reverse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. Once you get comfortable with the speed of 40, you can increase it to 60. I'll increase it to 60. And even if you get comfortable at that speed, you can even increase it to 70 or 80, whatever you want. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 2, 1. Got it. Let's bring this up a notch. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now instead of going into reverse, I'll shift one fret ahead. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll shift one fret ahead. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll shift. So once I reach the 12th fret, that's the 12th fret, two dots means 12th fret. So 3, 5, 7, the markers are all at odd places in the guitar. So 3, 5, 7, 9. But the only exception is the 12th fret that has two markers in it. And again back to 15, 17, again back to odd numbers, right? Yeah, so I do it up to the 12th fret. Starting from the first fret, now if I play it open, like the string open, that is called 0th fret, okay. So it doesn't have any fret over here, so that is called 0th fret. Yeah, I'll start with the first fret. I'm doing it fast just for the showing you, demonstrating you the whole exercise, and then I'll do it in reverse. On the 6th string, then I'll do the same thing on the 5th string. Reverse. You don't have to play at my speed, okay? Just set it to 40 and increase it to 60, and then I'll use the 4th. Like that. For all the students, that would be your exercise number 1. Your exercise number 2 would be 1-2 exercise. So that was 1-2-3-4 exercise. Number 2 is 1-2 exercise. 1-2-2-3-3-4. 1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2. Moving down. 1-2-1-2-1-2. Moving up. 1-2 means 1st fret and 2nd fret, as I said. 2-3 means the 2nd and 3rd fret with the 2nd and 3rd finger. So I'm just 2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3-2-3 like that. So 3-4-3-4-3-4. Again back. Combining whole exercise. Mind you, I am just using downstrokes. Now, 3rd and 4th would be the toughest one. Okay, so that would be exercise number 2, exercise number 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, exercise number 2, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4. So always spare about 10 to 15 minutes doing these two exercises. Start at the speed of 40, and so like that, and increase it as much as you can, like as much as you can play. Yeah, so these were the two exercises for building up your strength and agility on the guitar. And the 3rd exercise could be the stretching exercise. You can do the stretching exercise like 1-2 means 1st fret and 2nd fret. 1-3 over here. As we are doing the stretching exercise, we will do the 1st and 2nd finger. 1-2, then 1-3. If you can't play it over here, play it from the 5th fret. So 1-2, 1-3. 3, 2, 4. Sorry, yeah, we'll do it with the 1st finger, okay? 1-2, 1-3, 1-3, 1-4. So 1st finger stays where it is. 1-2, 1-3, 1-3, 1-4, 1-4, 1-5. Like that. So that would be a stretching exercise. Do it on all strings. By the time you are doing this, your speed would get developed, strength would get developed, flexibility would get developed, and these three exercises are most crucial thing. Now I'll give you a quick recap of what we did. First, we learned the parts of the guitar. We learned how to hold it. We learned how to hold a pick. We learned types of guitar. We learned the right hand technique. We learned the left hand technique. And the exercises that you will be doing are the right hand technique. This skipping exercise. And 1-2-3-4. 1-2-1-2. 2-3-2-3-3-4-3-4 like that, and then stretching, right? If you can't stretch from the 1st fret, you can do it from the 5th fret as well. So 5th fret is where the 2nd dot is. And keep in mind that 1st finger stays where it is. So let me give you a short in future what could we do with guitar. We can play melody.
happy birthday to you on a single string. So that is called melody on a single string. Or then once we learn scales, we can actually play it on. That is on scales. Scales are very important. Now there are two types of scales, major scale and minor scale. Major scale is Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. Minor scale is Sa Re Ga Ma Pa Dha Ni Sa. Yeah. After learning scales, so melody on single string, melody on scales, like melody on scales comes after learning scales. So melody on single string, just to keep your interest running, then we'll learn scales, then we'll learn melody on the scales. After playing melody on the scales, then we'll move towards the chords. Open chords, there are 8 open chords, like A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay, music range is of 7 letters, it goes from A to G, and that is kind of theory part that also I'll be covering. Okay, now how to form major scales, how chords are formed, how triads are formed, what are inversions. There are a lot of things. Okay, I can't explain it on a single session, so I'm just giving you a demonstration of what we can do. We can play songs after that. Strum. That is called strum. Okay. Volume stuff, Western stuff, finger style. Okay, finger picking also will. I found a love for me. Darling, just tie around and follow my lead. Life I'm blind. Beautiful and sweet. I never knew you were the sun waiting for me. Cause we were the skies when we fell in love. No, no, no. Like that. Finger picking, strumming, chords, and many other stuff. Okay. Thanks for watching this. I hope you like it. This is your guitar teacher, Canon TVD, signing off. Thank you.